The next question was to compare the Cistanche Armena and Cistanche Philippa composition of endosymbiotic communities. This was based on 60 RNA sequencing, and we look on the common species, and this is the dark one, gray, green, or specific for Cistanche Philippea, this from Portugal, and specific for Cistanche Armena. As you see, they are different species of bacteria based on 60 RNA sequencing. However, they are both similar for two species, but unique also. Then next question was, is indeed those endobiome of the two seeds differs or similar? So we look on the level of phylum. As you see, Cistanche armena has relatively low level of varied bacteria, and dominated are proteobacteria with some amount of Acinetobacter, whereas more rich is Cistanche philippea, which from Portugal, which in addition to Firmicutes, they contain Bacteroides, and then on class level, when you see the family of bacteria, again, Cistanche philippa from Portugal are more rich and more diverse than contrary to Cistanche armena from this semi-desert salty sum. They are relatively, the composition of course are different also, as you see on this. And next step, we do the microbiome, the whole microbiome, not only 60 RNA, but we isolated the DNA from both Cistanche armena and Cistanche philippa. And looking for, we do several sequencing, and we look on type of the phyla, and you see Cistanche armena are characterized by Firmicutes, Proteobacteria, Acinetobacteria. As concerned the orders, they are Penibacillus and Bacillaceae, with typical family for Penibacillus, like Penibacillus. For Bacillaceae, we identify genera Psychobacillus, Bacillus, and Damibacillus. From Proteobacteria, exactly from Gamma Proteobacteria, strain, not strain, but family, which we identify is Pterophyllomonas, Pseudomonas, and Serratia. As concerned Acinetobacter, the two species were able to identify Microbacterium and Cartibacterium. Those table presented the non-cultivable dominated endophytic bacteria on seed of Cistanche armena. On next step, we try to see the bacteria which are able to be cultivated. On this experiment, the methods which we used is the washing by physiological saline solution. So not the harsh condition by sulfuric acid or peroxide, but just saline washing. On this case, we were able to isolate it from Cistanche armena 34 different species. And this is the table of, you see, cultivable endophytic bacteria. And the percentage of this bacteria on a whole genome, which was able to cultivate. Only two phyla were able to grow on this condition, Firmicutes and Bacillaceae, which was 27% was Penibacillus, dominated by Bacillus, which was 41%, and other 11. Another group of phyla, Gamma Proteobacteria, we identify Pantonea, 30%, and the Stenophenoplast, which was almost 5%. as you see, again, dominated are spore-forming bacteria. Those bacteria need to survive, have ability to produce the spores. The question which we have for this cultivable bacteria is, do they produce so-called growth-promoting factor? And indeed, those isolated 35 strain have the ability to produce EAA, organic acid, and acetylases. They differ on this ability among the families, and for example, Penibacillus does not have ability to produce organic acid. And the percentage of this Bacillus family, Bacillaceae family, have all these abilities. And so the growth promoting factor differs between isolates. And then the color, of course, show the siderophore. The another green is siderophore. This is the proteins or amino acid able to suck off the iron from the environment. And only Bacillaceae possess these unique features. So in conclusion, we can say that our study have shown that majorities of the message take to home, that majorities of endophytes isolated from seed of three species are spore-forming bacteria. Those bacteria produce growth-promoting factor that may help to calm the stress related with abiotic condition like high amount of salt, high temperature, and may help seeds germination. And finally, methods of seed sterilization and DNA or endosymbiont isolation need to be adjusted to plant species. Unfortunately, there is no general methods which might be used for different seeds of the parasiting plants. However, I would like to stress that this final conclusion that this PGP factor may help to germination need to be proved. This is our hypothesis, because so far we don't have the proof for that, although we do preliminary study to growing not parasitic plants, but other plants. There's a lot of literature on the role of bacteria on the promoting growth of another plants, but not parasitic plants. So this is the photos from the Botanical Garden of University of Michigan, US, when I have occasion to lecture. And this is the kind of circle which is advisable for students to walk around and thinking over how to pass the exam. So I let you with this information to think over about complexity of the nature and relation between parasitic and non-parasitic plants, which might be very useful for many other sources. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Wiesław, for so amazing presentation and for some new data for us. May I ask a small first question? This endophytic bacteria from parasitic plants exerts the PGP effects towards the parasitic plant or towards the host plant as well?
Actually, we don't know the answer on this question, to be honest, because we studied this strain without presence of the both parasitic and host plants. However, we cannot exclude that during the germination and build up the haustarium, which is the organ needed to connect the parasitic plant with host, the bacteria may also grow, and then all biochemical triads might be useful for this purposes.
Thank you. We have another questions, and first of them, the question is, where do you think you are more likely to find and defeat bacteria that are promising for agriculture biotechnology? In weeds, in parasitic plants, or in cultivated plants?
Actually, we start the study both in tissue of the host plants, on seeds, and on the flowers. So we collect the material and we isolated bacteria from all these seeds, non-seeds and tissue plants, but the microbiome of each specific place are different. The bacillaceae are present in all on sites. However, the gamma proteobacteria, gram-negative bacteria, are present only on non-mature seed and the tissue of plants. So it means they are seed-specific, probably microbiome, which is very dynamic and changing because of the haustorium are moving inside of the tissue of the host plants, which also has their own bacterial microbiome.
And to have a next question. Thank you so much, Professor. The question is, it's well known now that the human microbiome phages play a significant role. What do you think? Could you expect from studying phages in such microbiomes of plants?
Very good question, because bacteriophages are the working force of evolution, and only these bacteria who are resistant to phages may survive. And the surface of bacteria are changing constantly due to the pressure of the phages. Indeed, we don't have tools, to be honest, to study environmental, except of the molecular methods. Because those strain which we isolated are growing not nicely. They need a week some time to be cultivated. Sometime does not survive to storage. So in order to study the phages, we need the host bacteria. And this is a question, which kind of the host is able to cultivate efficiently. Because as you may know, the bacteriophages are growing only on the logarithmic phase of the bacteria, the infected them. So the molecular methods may allow us to see the bacteriophages or prophages. And we do the whole sequencing NGS of the isolated species, hoping to find out prophages and then let the information go and see the phages which are really growing, not only be as a prophage. So this is our plan in future.
And the last short question, I think so. The question is, does the diversity of endophytic bacteria depend on the degree of aggressiveness of parasitic plant?
Well, good question, but I don't know the answer, to be honest. This is evolution for years, and both host and parasitic plants fix together. And this bacteria are surely the soil bacteria. They are coming from the soil. This is the fact, but only few of them survive on inside of the plant. So I don't know the answer to this question.
Thank you again for your amazing presentation. Thank you very much, Vyacheslav. And our next